everybody, it's Alexis here and welcome back to my channel. If you don't know who I am and you don't know what I do, I'm a floral designer. In this YouTube channel, I help others jumpstart their floral design career. So if you have a passion to become a florist or you just love flowers, subscribe to this channel and follow me on Instagram at flowersbyalexis. Now, in today's video, we're gonna talk about the difference between finishing touch spray and crowning glory. Now, for a while, I was literally just using Crowning Glory on literally everything. I was just spraying it on all my flower arrangements and being like, oh cool, this is great. But I actually recently learned that there was a difference between these two. So I thought it'd be cool to make a video on this because I personally didn't know there was a difference between the two. I literally thought they were just the same thing. So thought it'd be a good idea to make a video on it and explain the differences between these two. And so that way you guys can utilize them and make your flower arrangements last longer. So the first spray we're going to talk about is Crowning Glory. This is the spray that I was spraying on literally all of my arrangements. I thought that this was like the best thing to ever do. When my flowers would come in from the wholesaler, I would pull the Crowning Glory out and I would like spray all my flowers when they came in from the wholesaler because I thought that this was the right thing to do. I thought that this was great to help keep the flowers lasting long as possible. But I recently learned that that is not the right thing to do. So this is how you're supposed to use Crowning Glory. Crowning Glory is used when you don't have any water source for your flowers. For example, if you're making like a corsage, which are flowers that aren't getting water, they're just like sitting on your wrist, or boutonniere, which again, flowers aren't in water, they're just sitting on your clothing, you would spray Crowning Glory. When you spray your flowers with Crowning Glory, it provides a waxy finish to the flowers, which help locks in the moisture to the flowers, leaving them to last longer. This stuff will help keep your flowers more vibrant and looking fresher for longer. Now we're going to talk about finishing touch spray. So what I really like about finishing touch spray is that it helps prevent like premature browning and drooping of the flowers. This stuff is good because although it does lock in the moisture, it still allows the flower to get moisture from the water and the flower food. Highly recommend to check out some of this finishing touch spray if you haven't already. I will provide links to both of these sprays down in the description box below. If you use my links, I will get a little bit of commission off of them. So if you want to support me in this channel and help me pay my bills. What I like about both of these sprays is that they dry clear. So like I was always afraid to spray my flowers because I was like, oh my God, like what if it leaves like a waxy residue? Like, will I see that? Like, is it visible on the flowers? I haven't seen it. It's like a clear coating. I don't see it at all. It doesn't feel any different. Like the flowers don't feel like grimy or gross or anything like that. They feel pretty normal. I know some of you guys are sitting there thinking like, okay, this is all great and all, Alexis, but how do I actually use these sprays? This is what you do. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take either one of these sprays, Crowning Glory or Finishing Touch, either one. And for both of these sprays, you're just gonna wanna spray the arrangement twice. You're gonna let it sit for 30 minutes before you put it in the cooler. This will allow the waxing and all of the coatings on each of these sprays to settle on the flowers before putting them into the cooler. This whole like 30 minute wait process is like really important. I've learned that when I spray my flowers and then I just put them directly in the cooler and I use Crowning Glory, I have found that the flowers actually start to brown and wilt. So if you want to prevent that and you like don't want that to happen, I recommend just letting the flowers sit for like 30 minutes just to like let the coating like sit and dry on the flowers. Or I don't know if it's like the moisture with the flowers and the cold just like making the flowers brown and wilt faster. I don't know if that's what it is for sure, but I think that's what it is. And depending on the types of flowers you're using, how it was cultivated, the time of year, your climate, all of that, whatever, this spray will actually help keep your flowers lasting long, up for an additional 3 to 5 days. Now, that's amazing, guys. That's really freaking cool. So I literally spray this stuff on like all of the flower arrangements that I send out to people so that way my flowers last as long as possible in their home. I feel like this stuff is really awesome. If you're not already like spraying your flowers with any type of preservative, you need to start doing that. It will definitely make your flowers last longer. You will notice you're gonna start getting like better reviews because people are gonna call you back and be like, oh my God, my flower arrangement is still alive. Like it's been like a week and a half and it's still looking good. Like I've had people call me back and say that. And I really feel like it's because I use these two sprays right here. These guys are what saved me. So, you know, if you wanna just have a little extra insurance knowing that your flowers are gonna last long. You know, like, flowers are expensive, guys. Like, you don't want your stuff to die. So I got these for 10 bucks each at my flower wholesaler in person. When I was looking on Amazon, I actually learned that they're only like $7. So, all right guys, so that's the video, but I do have a little exciting announcement to make. So in next week's video, I'm going to be going over some like floral design basics. A lot of you guys are messaging me asking me to make like a floral design for beginners video. So I thought this would be kind of fun to make. All right guys, so that's the video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button in the corner. Turn on those bell notifications so that way you get notified when I upload a new video. Follow me on Instagram @flowersbyalexis, and I will see you all soon with another video. Bye.